You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we look at what's new in the Cognitive Services Face API. It's pretty cool. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this special build edition of the AI Show, where we're going to learn all about what's new in the Cognitive Services Special Face API. I've got a special guest with me. Hello, my friend. Tell us who you are and what you do.
Hello. Good morning. My name is Boris Januszpolski. I work on the Face API Cognitive Services team.
Fantastic. So for those that don't know what Cognitive Services are, can you give us just a little refresher?
Yeah, so Cognitive Services is a suite of pre-built AI models that are delivered via the cloud and via the edge, and they allow developers to quickly infuse AI capabilities into their applications without needing to have machine learning or computer vision expertise.
So for those that don't know about face recognition, can you give us a little primer?
Yeah, so facial recognition cognitive service has three key capabilities. One is face detection. So you can provide it images and we will return you back bounding boxes of faces if faces are found in images. We will also return you additional information for every face that's found in the image. The number two capability is face verification. So this is the ability to compare two faces and determine whether they belong to the same person or not. And capability number three is facial identification, which is basically look at an image and answer the question, who is it, relative to a list of enrolled faces.
I see. Now, are these hard to use in the Face API? What does a developer have to do to make this functionality work?
Yeah, so to make this functionality work, you need to create a Face API resource in the Azure portal. Then we offer a number of SDKs in various languages that you can use to quickly get started. We also offer a number of samples that you can use as a quick starting point. Generally, the calling pattern for all of these APIs is you take an image and you first call detect, and we will return you a set of information that you can either use to reason over an image, or if you want to use verification or identification, then the information we return from the detect API can be further used to make a verify or identify call.
So not much, just basically call an endpoint and then it does it for you.
Yep. Call an endpoint. It does it for you. There's great samples and documentation that you can use to quickly get started.
That's really cool. But now for the part where like everyone's come here for, what's new in the Face API for this year's build?
Yeah. So we have been investing in a couple of big areas based on what we hear from customers and partners today. One is the infrastructure side of our cognitive services, including Face API. So a few key things that we've been doing. Number one is we've been expanding our regional coverage, so bringing the service to more and more regions as Azure announces new regions. And if you look on the Face API website today, on the documentation, you can see all the regions where the service is available today. We've also added Azure Active Directory support. So now instead of just using an app key to authenticate into the Face API service, you can also use an Azure Active Directory identity. We've added VNet support, so now you can restrict what applications can actually interact with the Face API service to further lock down the access rights to the facial recognition APIs for in your tenant. And then last but not least, we've started rolling out the ability that we call customer managed keys, which allows you to specify the encryption key that should be used to encrypt templates of faces that are stored within the Face API service. By default, we encrypt them with a Microsoft managed key. With this capability, you can encrypt them with your own key and you can rotate the key as frequently as you require.
And this is really cool because basically we're giving customers the ability to manage this at a more fine-grained level, it looks like.
Yep. And we're putting customers in control of all of these capabilities so that they can increase the security posture of their end-to-end applications.
So with a customer-managed key, essentially, even Microsoft cannot see what's in there because the keys are managed by the customer.
That is correct. Yep, the keys are managed by the customer, and it also allows the customer to manage the rotation schedule of these keys, which we have seen as important to a number of customers.
Amazing. So what's new on the AI side? Because the infrastructure side is cool, but let's see about the AI side.
Yeah, so on the AI side, the first thing we've done after talking to many developers is we've actually added the ability to for side-by-side support for detection and recognition models. This is really meant to make sure that we do not introduce backward compatibility issues as we roll out new face detection and face recognition models. So what happens is when we have a new face detection or face recognition model, we ship it as an additional model to the models that are already supported in the service. And we empower the developers to pick when they want, if and when they want to use that new capability. And that allows them to test it with their data, make sure that they set up the right thresholds, and only then roll out changes into their service. But this really protects developers from any backward compatibility issues and puts developers in control.
That's awesome.
Number two is what we've heard from customers is while the Face API service works well for frontal faces, we have seen that non-frontal faces or small faces would not always be detected by the Face API service. So we've added a new detection model that is specifically trained towards finding faces that are non-frontal or very small or partially occluded. And then the other core capability that we've added is a brand new facial recognition model. Based on benchmarks that we have done, we have seen improvements up to 25% in accuracy, both in terms of false positives and false negatives. This model is available in the service today. You can use it. The one challenge to be aware of, in order to use this new recognition model, you need to recreate any enrollments that you already have. Because we do not store images of faces that are used for enrollment, we only store the templates that are generated from these images. In order to use the new model, you need to re-enroll faces with that new model. And again, I'll point to a link in the documentation on the next slide.
And again, but that's because like we're not storing people's faces. And so it's like if you're using a new model,
precisely,
we don't have your faces because we're trying to be ethical here, which is really cool.
Yep. Yep, absolutely.
All right, so let's see if I can recap. Side-by-side support for multiple detection, that's basically if you're using a previous model, it will work still, but if you want to move to the next model, you can do that as well.
Yep, and you're absolutely in control of when you do it.
Fantastic. We have a new face detection model that does non-frontal faces, which is a pretty hard problem, I think.
Yep. It's a hard problem, and it also enables a new class of applications where you want to understand all the faces that are in the image that are not necessarily for recognition purposes, but for counting or blurring or other scenarios.
That's cool. And then finally, we've been hard at work making a brand new machine learning model to detect faces, and this is the outcome of that effort.
Yep.
All right. Well, where can people go to find out more?
Here are the links to the online documentation for Azure AD identity support, VNet, customer managed keys, as well as the new recognition models.
This is all very cool stuff. Thank you so much for spending some time with us on this, the AI show, my friend.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
All right, my friends, we're learning all about what's new in the Cognitive Services Face API here on the AI show. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time. Take care.